Hello everyone, it's Jessie and I'm back with another plan with me. So in this video, I am planning for the week of Lunar New Year, which is a holiday that a lot of Asian cultures celebrate, including mine. This year it landed on February 12th, so I am planning for that week and I'm using this beautiful Hey Soul sticker kit with amazing red tones and gold foiling. So I did things a little bit differently than my usual for this week. I first put down the full boxes at the bottom of the page, sort of like bottom washi, but then you'll see here that I'm actually ripping it up and I'm trying to be as careful as I can to not rip up the pages and ruin the stickers, but I essentially wanted to change the layout slightly differently in terms of spacing. So usually I just put down a single black line in between the days, but I wanted to go with a little bit more of a structured outline this time around. So you'll see here that I'm actually outlining the entire column for my days of the week, and I am freehanding it because honestly I was just too lazy to go upstairs and grab my ruler. But in the future, if I ever do this kind of layout again, I will be grabbing my ruler just because quite a few of my lines ended up wonky. I am not apparently as good as I thought I was in drawing some straight lines. So while I'm putting down the base of this spread, I did want to touch on something a little bit heavier this week. So as many of you may have heard from the news recently, there has been an increased level of racist incidents and hate crimes against Asians in the past year or so as the pandemic has been going on. And as an Asian American, this does hit really close to home, and it's with a heavy heart that I'm listening and watching to all of these news. You know, I was actually listening to a podcast recently and Ronnie Chang was a guest. And Ronnie Chang, as some of you may know, is a Malaysian comedian and he's also a senior correspondent on The Daily Show with Trevor Noah. So he was talking about, you know, as he was growing up, America was just seen as such a great place to be. Everybody talks about the American dream, and essentially the general sentiment was, if you've made it in America, then you're set. But recently, when he was talking to his relatives, they've started asking him questions like, when are you going to leave America? When are you coming back to our country? And it genuinely saddens me to hear about this shift in perception towards the US, especially because my own parents also worked extremely hard to get here and help provide for this life that I now have. Yet I cannot help but feel like a part of me, every once in a while, does feel like, oh, you know, what if we just moved to another country where this kind of stuff doesn't happen and you won't feel like you're not wanted where you're living. It's just really hard to open up the news and see headline after headline of all of these Asians who are being attacked. And, you know, when I actually saw the photo of one of the victims of the Atlanta shooting, I immediately started crying, which has never happened to me before in terms of like reacting so hard towards news, because it reminded me so much of my mom, right? And so that's just where I'm at right now. I just don't understand why people just can't treat other people with kindness. I mean, we're all humans and we're all on the same earth. Racism just boggles my mind and I just don't understand it. But I will be leaving some organizations in the description box who are working to help fight for the Asian community. If you do have the means to help donate, it would really mean a lot to me. So moving back to the plan with me, on Monday morning, I wanted to post about a Lunar New Year loop giveaway we were having. So I used a third box from the kit, and then I used a label sticker also from the kit to mark that I wanted to test, print, and cut some of the new releases that we were having, which included Pixar and Avengers sticker kits. I then put down a glitter header along with a half box and a fox and cactus emoji sticker to mark down that my ShipStation account wasn't working well that day. Something was going wrong, and so I used an annoyed girl from Fox and Cactus to mark that. It was very clearly how I was feeling about that incident. Afterwards, I put down some washi strips, and I spared you the footage of me actually putting those down because my fingers weren't listening to me well and I had trouble lining them up. But I also used a movie marquee from our shop to watch the Korean movie Call on Netflix. Ricky and I really enjoyed it. We went into it not knowing what to expect at all, and it turned out to be this really engaging thriller psychological film, and it was good. We really, really enjoyed it. Tuesday morning, I started out with a half box and a Bubba Bear Studios zombie looking girl on a laptop because I had a one-on-one meeting with my manager super early in the morning, way earlier than I normally get up, and so I was just feeling very, very tired. But the call went well and it was really good news overall, and so that made me really happy. And then something that did not make me happy afterwards was having to call customer service for ShipStation to figure out what the issues were. And so I used a hexagon sticker and a Coffee Monsters Co. emoji for that. Afterwards, I pulled another hexagon sticker from the kit along with a Planning Roses Instagram icon. I really like these because they're quite small and neutral colored, and so they fit with almost every spread. But I wanted to use it to mark down that I wanted to announce our new releases on Instagram and Facebook. Afterwards, I put down another glitter header for some foil and separation, and then a quarter box from the kit along with a Some Little Things sticker to mark down that I needed to do some mock spreads for our new releases. And so that little bunny planning with her stickers was a really appropriate thing to mark that with. I had a really terrible night's sleep on Tuesday, and so I used a half box along with what I believe is the Bubba Bear Studios older sticker. It's been a while, so I can't really remember 100% where that's from. I'm really sorry about that, but I thought it was appropriate because it was just somebody under the blankets giving the middle finger. So moving on to Wednesday, I started off with another glitter header and a page flag and this Fox and Cactus girl on a laptop sticker, and she's super stressed out, and this is actually my camera that fell over randomly. I managed to save it, but it was very, very scary. I didn't want to destroy my $800 camera. So moving back to the plan with me, I had to update some pre-sale processing times, and Etsy's UI was such a pain. I had to do that individually one by one for like almost 200 orders, and it was just a really, really time-consuming process. So I probably ended up looking like that girl afterwards. Ricky and I then cleaned the house, and I used a half box along with a Grin and Bear It cleaning bear sticker for that. We wanted to clean the house a few days before the new year actually started because there's like this whole tradition that you're not supposed to clean your house for a few days after the new year's, because at least for Chinese people, we think that like if you clean the house, then you're cleaning away all of your good luck and stuff like that. So I don't know if I fully believe in that, but it doesn't hurt to follow those customs. Afterwards, I recorded, edited, and did a voiceover, and so I used paper and milk stickers to mark that. And then Ricky and I played Little Nightmares 2. Well, I played Little Nightmares 2. He, for once, was the backseat player and was just watching me because some of my favorite games to play are platformer games with a creepy horror theme. Let me know if you guys like those kinds of games because I'm always looking to play more. But I used a gaming sticker from our shop to mark that. Thursday morning was just one of those days where I really needed some coffee, and so I marked Coffee Thursday along with a paper Kumiko coffee sticker. I'm not normally a coffee person. If you watch my plan with me, you'll know that I get milk tea a lot just because I'm pretty sensitive to caffeine, but yeah, Thursday was just one of those mornings. Afterwards, I used a page flag along with an upload sticker to mark down that I needed to put up my YouTube video. And then I used a header from the kit along with a three heart checklist for some shop things to do. So I needed to draft some listings, take some product photos, and then I panic bought blades because there was a time that month where Silhouette blades were just nowhere to be found. Like, they were sold out everywhere, and that's such an essential part of keeping my shop running. And so I scoured the web for any kinds of blades that I could find from like different websites, and I managed to grab a few. But yeah, I was really panicky. I then used a Coffee Monsters Co. envelope sticker to mark down that I wanted to apply for an online PO box. And then we ended that night with another Korean movie called Space Sweepers, also on Netflix, with a movie marquee from our shop. I didn't love that one as much as Call. I would give that movie maybe like a solid B minus. But Song Joong-ki, which is the main actor, is really easy on the eyes. And so part of the movie, part of the reason why I finished the movie was just to watch him on my screen. Friday, I started by cutting up a full box just because I wanted to use the foil part as a background for this Grin and Bear It label sticker that I'm using here. And I used it to mark down new releases and our sale. It started super early in the morning at 6 a.m. PST. Very sleepily started that sale, but it did go well. Thank you all so much for the support. I then used a half box along with a decorative sticker from the kit to mark down Happy New Year. So that character in the middle is the word for cow, which is the animal that this lunar New Year is. I'm not explaining that well. So every lunar New Year, or every new year, at least in the Chinese zodiac, corresponds to an animal, and this year is the ox or cow. So that is the character for cow, also pronounced Niu in Chinese. And so if you say it, it's kind of like Happy Niu Year, like a Happy New Year pun, ha ha ha. Anyways, I did some cutting, so I used a Hazel sticker cameo for that. And then we had a family dinner, which I marked down on a half box. So Saturday, I used another half box along with a Fox and Cactus cat sticker to mark down that one of my cats missed the litter box and there was a pee puddle everywhere in our like litter box area. I don't know who the culprit is and nobody's confessing. So that is great. I then finished the book, The Wicked King, which is part two of a series that I really enjoyed. I recommend that book if you like fantasy, adult, or YA novels. I then put down another glitter header and did some sticker surgery to a habit tracker full box. So I cut it in half and then I covered up the days of the week with this Paper Dove Shop Girl on a Laptop sticker because Ricky and I attended a Mike Birbiglia Zoom comedy show that day, which was really fun. So on Sunday, I first put down another full box at the bottom of the spread because I wanted to keep it consistent with all of the boxes at the bottom. I don't normally put down a full box at the bottom of the weekend, but Sunday was really light anyways in terms of what I did, and so I had the room. I then used the other half of the habit tracker box that I cut up, and then to cover up the Monday, I used an orange dot sticker from the kit and then a Some Little Things sticker to cover up the Tuesday and Wednesday portions. I hope that made sense. But I used those to mark that I finished the game Little Nightmares 2, which I thoroughly enjoyed. I felt like it was just the right amount of creepy and there was a twist at the end that I didn't see coming. So two thumbs up from me. So that is the end of my week. I really love how it turned out with all of the gold foiling. And as always, thank you very much for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!